In times to come, rallies alone will not help. It doesn't help at all. It draws the crowd, but to translate into votes, you require a cadre. And unless and until the Congress also pays attention in the next couple of years in building organization in the states where it once upon a time had a glorious past, but in recent parts, the regional parties has overtaken because they thought that there was a lack of regional aspiration being fulfilled by the national parties.
This election became Prime Minister Modi versus Naveen Patnaik. Where did the Congress disappear in the state politics?
No, that's true for Uttar Pradesh also.
No, in Uttar Pradesh, Congress has been insignificant for 20 odd years.
And
in Odisha, that was not the case.
That's what I'm saying. Since over the years in Odisha, the cadre has weakened over the years. The BJP had the opportunity to fill up the gap. So unless and until the party base is made strong in the next couple of years, you've got to work, you've got to enthusiast your cadre.
Okay.
You need to have people at the booth level who will translate votes for you. I think those are the important decisions that needs to be taken by the party.
Let's get in Rajesh Mahapatra, the man who's got his ear to the ground, who understands Odisha politics very well. Rajesh, explain to us that what swung it in favor of the BJP. When you look at these numbers, the Lok Sabha kitty, the poll of polls says 10, and you have some which actually go on to giving 12 seats to the BJP out of 21. What swung it for the BJP?
Gauri, let me sincerely advise you not to indulge in this exercise called poll of polls. You know, an arithmetic mean of polls that throw out very divergent results is a recipe for a disastrous prediction of what an election is going to be. I think most of the channels do it. I think it's one of the most unscientific ways, and they should desist from this practice. This is my view, and it's not a view. If you ask any sociologist, any person who is trained in this exercise, would tell you this.
Okay.
This is a highly unscientific approach. So let us first keep this unscientific approach aside. Now let us come down to the numbers. I still think that a lot of predictions that have been made by national surveys have really not scratched the surface enough in Odisha. And that is why you are seeing this inconsistency, that on the one hand you are predicting 10 to 11 to 12 seats, and on the other hand you are saying BJP will probably get around 30, 35, 40 is the most optimistic scenario. Now, as I explained earlier, if you do not win a Lok Sabha seat unless you are winning at least 3 MLA seats in a constituency. Now, the fact of the matter is that BJP, even though it built a huge narrative, even though it succeeded in turning the election into a Modi versus Naveen Patnaik contest, even though it significantly succeeded in creating a narrative that, you know, even if you vote for BJP at a state level, vote for the Lotus at a national level, because, this is what you need.
Okay.
I think that narrative worked in urban areas. But I still maintain, and I am still sticking to my initial assessment, that I do not agree with the gains that are projected for BJP. There will be some gains.
Okay.
I think they would win around 5 seats. In the best of situation, probably 6. You never know. 23rd will come to know. But as of now, that is my assessment.
Gopal Krishna Agarwal, respond to that.
Gauri, the thing I want to mention here is that you just cannot win election by just campaigning for the last 1.5 month or 2 months. You have to put effort for the whole 5 years. That's what Mr. Amit Shah told, that we had identified 120 seats which we lost in 2014, and we have been working on those 120 seats for the last 5 years. And that is the showing the result. Those who think that suddenly there is a way when we have won, it is not like that. It is a ground level effort and concerted effort of performance, communication, a party structure, all these together give results. So Indian politics is not that simple. that you just you are cannot
sir,
win
nothing
an
in life is so simple. Forget Indian politics. Nothing in life is so simple.
Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Gandhi.
You
got
to work your
present.
Way up to any victory, yes. Anything that happens. It, you know, hard work is what that translates into anything substantial. Yes. That holds true for life. But,
but
you know, Mr. Patnaik, I understand what you're saying. You're saying that, you know, 5 years, a lot of work has been done and effort has gone. Yeah. I understand that, sir. Mr. Patnaik, let me bring you in, sir. Mr. Patnaik, you know, obviously, Naveen Patnaik is now going to be, you know, or at least as per the polls, he is very comfortably home to be the CM for the fifth time. No doubt that there is a record that is being created here. But, you know, Soumyaranjan Patnaik, the question is, look at the kind of dent BJP has also made in the assembly. So while you have a majority, that victory margin from 117 in a house of 147, stellar in 2014, it has reduced quite significantly to the range of about 85 to 90. So to that effect, there is an impact on the BJP in the assembly as well, may not be at the same level as it was in Lok Sabha.
Certainly, even the enemies must accept that BJP has improved its political position in Orisha.
Is this a
there
lesson
no doubt
for
about
BJD?
That.
Is this a
but
lesson for BJD?
Time,
what do you learn from here?
Let me also warn you about one. Listen to me. This is only we're talking about an exit poll. Exit polls are not exact polls. 3 days down the line, you should talk about it 3 days. One thing you are all missing, in most of these cases, there are many seats where there is a very tight fight, very close fight. One cannot decide which side will win. The number of those seats, to my mind, is close to 24, 25. Out of these 25, in the parliamentary election, the number of those seats are close to 7 and 8. Out of 21 seats, the exit polls are showing almost 50-50, 10-11 to BJP and 10-11 to BJD, as compared to
Fair enough,
in the
sir.
Last
these are not final
parliament,
numbers, and I absolutely take that.
Improvement.
With all humility, sir, I accept that
these are not the final numbers, and we'll have a separate discussion on that day.
I agree with you, sir. But, you know, I have another question for you.
What I'm trying only to suggest, when the results come out on 23rd, you will find BJD will be getting much more numbers than you have on your screen.
Fair enough. But I am asking you a question, sir, irrespective of the final number, the trend, the exit polls gauge a broader trend. And most of the trend lines are pretty clear here. My question to you, sir, is that what is the learning for BJD here? Is it clear, is the writing on the wall clear that BJP, the saffron surge in the state of Odisha, is only going to amplify from here on because BJP is going to build onto this momentum from here on? What's the learning for the Biju Janata Dal party here, sir?
The learning is very clear. We are very strong with our own vote base. 44% vote base is an improvement of what we got last time.
Okay.
But what is more important is there is for the first time a massive tactical voting.
Okay.
People are voting in large number for one party in the assembly and they are voting for another party in the parliament.
Mm.
And let us not forget we are a regional party. Regional parties are not vying for power in centre.
Right.
So the people's perception may be we are electing Naveen Patnaik as the chief minister for the fifth time.
All right, okay.
We are not electing a prime minister.
Rajesh
Naveen
Mahapatra.
Patnaik was not contesting for the prime minister's position.
Rajesh Mahapatra.
Therefore, since the,
is this Rajesh
the
Mahapatra,
alternative to
I understand that, sir. Rajesh Mahapatra, is this the broad overarching theme of 2019 that state after state, the lessons are very clear, the electorate is getting smarter and wiser, and parties need to appreciate that?
No, I think you ask a very pertinent question. What is the lesson of this? If there has been a significant split voting, what is the lesson for BJD, a party like Biju Janata Dal? And I think the same question can be asked to regional parties elsewhere also. And the lesson is this. Regional parties today occupy 50% of the electoral space, but they do not occupy the same share in the political space because they do not indulge that they do not think it is necessary for them to create a national narrative. So the single most important message for Naveen Patnaik and his party would be that these results tell you that there is a need for a regional party to have a national imagination also. You cannot say that we will maintain a policy of equidistance, we will not talk about national issues, we will not bother about national issues just because we do not have national ambitions. That is not a good enough reason. If you pursue it, that's good enough, that kind of a line of thinking, sooner or later, regional parties either must have a strong regional agenda,
yes,
or they must have a national imagination behind them.
Soumyaranjan Patnaik, Naveen Patnaik needs to learn from Mamata Banerjee. Well, you know, everybody talks about her national ambitions all the time. Naveen Patnaik is so reluctant and reclusive. Nobody knows what's his opinion on many contentious issues. As Rajesh Mahapatra is saying, you've got to think national, not just local.
I just wanted to add one more point, Gauri.
We are certainly part of the national scenario, but as a regional party, we know our own limitations, we know our priorities, Odisha's interest, Odisha's politics, and regional party in Odisha with 21 seats cannot aspire for national leadership.
All right. Okay.
Therefore, let us be. I'm trying only to be very realistic.
Okay. Practical
one must have a
here.
National narrative. One must have a national perspective.
Okay.
But one must not forget its own limitation.
All right. Practical politics. Quick 20 seconds, Vikas. I wrap this up as we talk about the learnings for regional party here.
You know, I think that's a very fair point that's been made, that wherever the regional parties have a national aspiration, they've done well in this exit poll. If be it the state of Uttar Pradesh, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, or even down south in Tamil Nadu also, where DMK is sweeping the poll.
Yes.
So I think the regional aspiration that they, in a federal structure,
yes,
having a state government and also supporting a government at the center,
right,
means a lot, not only for the central government rule, but also they work in tandem with the state government for the upliftment of the people for the state schemes.
All right. On 23rd of May, of course, is when we know the final figures and what really the people of Odisha have said. On that note, I need to wrap this up. Thanks much to all our panelists. We need to slip into a quick break. We come back on the other side and discuss my faith versus your faith. The netas have unabashedly chosen to display their religious faith in 2019. What does that mean going forward? Is the template been set? We're going to discuss that after this break. Stay tuned.
Box Zebra, open for fun.
You think that you know my heart, and you probably do. So I'm more.